Hello, children. Hope you enjoy our lessons. As you all know by now, English as a life skill is your dear friend to help you improve your English language skills. Welcome you all to another very important lesson.
Don't forget, we have homework. We have to write a letter, Vindhya.
Yes, a formal letter. I have no idea how to write it.
Let's write it together. Can you come to our house in the evening?
Sure, I will come.
I'm going in. Goodbye.
Bye.
Yes, children. I'm sure you all can guess what we are going to discuss today. Yes, it's writing formal letters. Let's see how Hasini is going to write it with Vindhya. They are going to write a formal letter.
Please read the situation again, Hasini.
Imagine you're the secretary of the English Literary Association. You're going to have a program to celebrate the Children's Day. You're going to celebrate the Children's Day with the grade 11 students of the neighboring school, MC Tamil School. Write a letter to the principal of that school informing about it.
Well, children, is it clear to you? They are going to write a letter to the principal of the neighboring school. Let's see how they are going to do the task.
How do we write it? Have you got any idea?
Let's write it and show it to mother. She will help us.
What shall we write first?
First, our address.
Vindhya Karuna Ratna.
Oh no, Vindhya, not your address. The secretary's address. Malgama Vidyalaya.
Wait. Malgama Vidyalaya. Malgama.
Next, the date.
20th September.
Right. The receiver's address. The principal. MC Tamil School, Malgama. Then you have to write, Dear Sir, here. And after that, the topic of the letter.
Topic of the letter? How to write that?
Let's write, Children's Day celebrations. Write it in the middle of the sheet.
Next.
Now, we can start the letter like this. Our English Literary Association has decided to celebrate the Children's Day.
Our English Literary Association.
We would like to invite grade 11 students of your school to join us.
Oh, you are too fast. Please read it slowly.
Oh, sorry, Vindhya, I'll read it slowly. We would like to invite grade 11 students of your school to join us. Please confirm your participation.
Is this enough? Don't we have to thank the receiver?
Yes, we have to. After that, you can end the letter now.
How?
Write, yours, leave space for the signature, and then you can write the secretary, English Literary Association.
It's over. Fine.
English as a life skill.
Children, you saw how they wrote the letter. Now, let's have a look at the full letter they have written. Please go through the format of that letter very carefully. It's very important.
Mother, we have homework to write a letter.
What is the letter?
Here's the question.
We wrote it, Mother. Please correct it.
Let me see. It has to be a formal letter. Let me see what you have written. First, you have to write the sender's address.
Auntie, will you please correct if there is a mistake?
No, dear. I don't have to correct it. The sender's address is correct. The date is also correct. You have written the receiver's address here. Great, that's also correct. Well done, children.
Thank you, Auntie.
Next is the salutation. Okay, you have written it. You have written, dear sir. Very good.
Yes, you are watching how Hasini's mother is giving feedback to what they have written. See how happy they are. I hope you are also learning it while watching this. Shall we recollect them again?
Next is the topic. Is the way we have written the topic correct?
You have to align the topic to the center. Let me see. You have done it. This is about organizing a program, isn't it? You have written it right.
Yes, Auntie. It is our Children's Day program.
Yes, you have underlined the topic as well. Now, let's see how you have written the body of the letter.
Sure, Auntie. Hasini, please read what we wrote in this letter.
Our English Literary Association has decided to celebrate the Children's Day. We would like to invite grade 11 students of your school to join us. Please confirm your participation.
At the end of the body, you must write thank you.
Yes, Auntie. We have written it.
Yours faithfully here.
We have written that too.
Of course you have. It's really great. The secretary at the end. That is the way you must end a formal letter.
Yeah, Hasini, we have made it.
Yes, girls, you have done it. Very good. Can you read it again?
The Secretary, English Literary Association, Malgama Vidyalaya, Malgama, 20th September. The Principal, MC Tamil School, Malgama. Dear Sir, Children's Day Celebrations. Our English Literary Association has decided to celebrate the Children's Day. We would like to invite grade 11 students of your school to join us. Please confirm your participation. Thank you. Yours faithfully, the secretary.
English as a life skill.
You were watching how Vindhya wrote the formal letter and how Hasini's mother gave feedback. Shall we see the letter again? The Secretary, English Literary Association, Malgama Vidyalaya, Malgama,
20th September.
The Principal, MC Tamil School, Malgama. Dear Sir, Children's Day celebrations. Our English Literary Association has decided to celebrate the Children's Day. We would like to invite grade 11 students of your school to join us.
Please confirm your participation.
Thank you. Yours faithfully, the Secretary.
Is something missing in this letter? Is there a date of the function? At what time is the function? Where is it held? Yes, they are missing in this letter. When you write a letter, it is very important to mention all this information. Now, shall we add all this information to the letter?
The Secretary, English Literary Association, Malgama Vidyalaya, Malgama,
20th September.
The Principal, MC Tamil School, Malgama. Dear Sir, Children's Day celebrations. Our English Literary Association has decided to celebrate the Children's Day. We would like to invite grade 11 students of your school to join us.
It will be held on the 1st of October at 10 a.m. in the school main hall. Please confirm your participation.
Thank you. Yours faithfully, the Secretary. Let's look at the parts of the formal letter again. Sender's address. Next, the date. Receiver's address. Salutation. The heading. The body of the letter. The ending. The signature and the designation. Now, you know the structure of a formal letter. We hope you can write a formal letter now. Shall we try to arrange this letter in order? Yours faithfully. We need 20 dozens of exercise books. Please let me know if you can supply the books by the 1st of October. We hope you would deliver them to our school. Thank you. Social Services Association, Suvandakoda Mahavidyalaya, Suvandakoda. Nimal Jayanta, the Secretary. Dear Sir, ordering exercise books. The Manager, Adipa Bookshop, Colombo. 5th July. Can you tell what this part is? Number 1. It is the ending. What is this part? Number 2. It is the body of the letter. Number 3. It is the address of the sender. What's number 4? This is the signature and the designation. What's number 5? Salutation. Can you tell what number 6 is? This is the heading. What's number 7? The letter is about buying some books. So, this is the receiver's address. This is the date of the letter. Shall we arrange this letter part by part correctly? Social Services Association, Suvandakoda Mahavidyalaya, Suvandakoda. 5th July. The Manager, Adipa Bookshop, Colombo. Dear Sir, ordering exercise books. We need 20 dozens of exercise books. Please let me know if you can supply the books by the 1st of October. We hope you would deliver them to our school. Thank you. The Secretary. We hope that you will be able to answer the question on writing a formal letter in the GCE O-level English language paper now. Wish you all the best. Thank you for being with us.